I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making chocolate peanut clusters and we're using vanilla bark and also chocolate bark. And I've brought the packages so you can see what I'm working with. This package holds 24 ounces of vanilla bark coating. I only need 8 ounces. So this actually had 3 of these bars in it and I took one of them. And this is a very similar package, chocolate bark coating. And it has the complete 3 that I just took out after opening this. So I only need 1 of those strips. So what we are getting is 8 ounces of the vanilla bark coating and 8 ounces of the chocolate bark coating. I'll put back the rest of the chocolate, which I will use on something later. And our vanilla is used up because I had a previous recipe that used our vanilla bark. Now I'm going to put those pieces into a bowl and melt them. But it will be easier to melt them if I cut them into squares. And some of the cutting is already done, but the rest of it I just need to cut through at the places that are indicated. And that's just to speed up the melting of the chocolate and the vanilla. So make sure you have a large enough bowl, about a 2-quart bowl would be fine. Now, these go to a microwave oven on high and will be cooked, or you might say melted, for about 2 to 3 minutes. But you stop every 30 seconds and stir. So I'm going to keep track of what's going on with this. And if it only takes 2 cycles, 30 seconds each, that's fine. You want to stop when it's melted and maybe when there are still a few lumps in it. So to the microwave, and then we'll be back to continue our recipe. This is what I have after 3 30-second cycles. And for me, that's good enough. I see a lump here and there, but I know that they're going to melt. As I stir this and see those streaks, it reminds me to tell you that you could make this all vanilla if you like that, or you could make it all chocolate. And sometimes that's determined by what happens to be in your pantry at the time. But they're both good. This is just kind of a compromise between vanilla and chocolate. So it's a very light milk chocolate. Now we need some peanuts. And these happen to be dry roasted peanuts, and they are salted, lightly salted. You can get the kind that is unsalted if that's what you prefer. This is 1 pound. So I'm going to open it up. I've already opened it and removed this top panel so we could pour these, and all of these go in. It's going to be very peanutty. Let's stir this around. Get all the peanuts coated. So this looks about right, and you need to have a prepared pan or dish that you're going to use. And I've chosen this large dish, and I don't think it's going to hold all of this, but we'll just see how far this goes. For a dish like this, I think this is approximately 11 by 15 by 2. And it doesn't need that depth. I just happen to have this dish. You need to line it with something. It could be aluminum foil, wax paper, parchment paper. I had this silicone pad, which I just threw in there because that was the easiest thing to do. But some kind of a cover, just so these will come off easily when you get ready to remove them. And then if you want to keep them equal sized, use something like a scoop, such as this one, of whatever size that you might want for your clusters. And then go over here, remembering the size that you have so you can duplicate it again and again. And this will be runny, but it won't run too far. So just let it sit there and continue to get these in scoopfuls that are about the same size. And we could probably put 3 across here So I'm just going to continue and it will fill this, and probably I will have some to go on another pan. Here we have our chocolate peanut clusters, and you can see that we have a dozen in this dish that I had started on for you. And then I got out a pan, which was similar, and I ran out right when I was getting close to another dozen. So you get an idea of how many it makes. These are all roughly the same size. But after letting them sit for about a half hour, then I refrigerated them for another half hour and they're ready. So it's just a really quick thing to do. What you need to do now, they should hold together with no problem. You just want to remove them from either the seal pad or the wax paper, whatever you have, and put them on a nice serving plate. I'll move over here to get a couple. Just to show you, they are just absolutely smooth on the bottom because of that coating bark. It's really easy to work with, even if you're making bonbons or something like that and want some chocolate to dip in, either white chocolate or dark chocolate. Using this is just so easy. So I need to finish getting these on a plate and I'll be back to take a taste. Here are our finished chocolate peanut clusters, and they look delicious, and they can be served just from a plate like this. I'm going to take one over here to my plate, and I have made myself a fresh cup of coffee. This is black. I usually drink my coffee black, and that's only to save calories because I'd rather have it with all of these spiced creams and things like that. Occasionally I will do that, but it has to be a real treat. There is some bourbon here, some Maker's Mark dressed up in case you want to serve your coffee with a splash of that. But let's figure out what these clusters taste like. Probably chocolate and peanut. Mmm, they are so nutty. They're so compact with nuts, which you could tell by looking at it. But the eating of it, it's more than a payday in terms of the way the nuts are packed around. I think it's very tasty and very good. I don't want to eat more right now because I've been making a lot of candy lately. But I just wanted to show you this recipe because it's so super simple. But it's something that you will have made from your heart. So it's a good gift to give. Or if you're having people over, you can have it as something to pass around. This is something you could use as a gift, like we've mentioned in some of the other videos. If you could just get a tin that is Christmassy, they're very inexpensive, and put what you want in there. And then close it tightly. And I would suggest that you wrap what's inside or put it in a bag, maybe dress it up a little bit so it will look very much like a gift. Then you know it's going to taste good and it's going to be probably very appreciated. So I have probably done the last really sweet treat that I plan to do for Christmas. So I want to wish you all a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. But I'll see you back soon.